very unusual time to bid farewell to an extraordinary man, Brother Justice Deepak Gupta. A man of multifaceted talents, an avid trekker, a keen environmentalist, a talented photographer. He is demitting office as a judge of the Supreme Court. Today, I don't wish to say farewell, my brother. I want to congratulate you for all that you have achieved in life so far and all that you will accomplish in the days to come. I wish you and your family, Madam Poonam, a very gifted artist, and your two talented daughters, Dia and Damini, a very, very happy and peaceful life. May you live well, stay safe, and achieve greater glory.
Hi. If one applies the theory of relativity, one will find that those who serve well an institution to the best of their ability, with absolute commitment and dedication, retire earlier than the other creed. The retirement of Justice Deepak Gupta, in my humble opinion, has come a little too early if you apply this theory. He was a true Karma Yogi to whom the attributes of Adveshta Sarva Bhutanam Maitraha Karuna Yevacha Nirmamo Nirahankaraha Samadukta Sukakshami Adveshta Sarva Bhutanam. With no malice towards any living being, Maitraha, friendly with everyone, Karunayevacha, very compassionate, Nirmamo Nirahankaraha, with no attachment or ego, Samadukka Sukha, treating good and bad as equal, Kshami, forgiving, all these attributes will apply to Justice Deepak Gupta. It is said that retirement is the only time when you can have a life without having a job. It is the time of your life when you find, while waking up in the morning, that you have nothing to do, and find at bedtime that you have accomplished only half of that task. Retirement is the opportunity that life gives you to stop complaining about not having the time or chance to do what you always wanted. Though my friendship with Justice Deepak Gupta as a colleague on the bench is only about 7 months young, we have known each other from 2017 when we first met in the Chhattisgarh High Court. Somehow he took a liking for me and it played a part, particularly in my going to his parent High Court as Chief Justice. Justice Deepak Gupta is one of those who arrive early for the morning coffee in the judges' lounge, and it used to be great fun to have him around. We, the early birds at the lounge, will certainly miss him. But one day, all of us will catch up with him. Until then, have a good time and wait for us, sir. Goodbye.
Justice Deepak Gupta, I am limited by the constraint of time. It is customary on such occasions to reminisce about the person whom you are speaking. My fondest memory goes back to the time when you, as a sitting judge of the Himachal Pradesh High Court, came and sat in the courtroom, just unobtrusively observing the proceedings of the e-court. Well, if I were to describe you and your attributes, compassion, humility, care and concern for the marginalized, the deprived and those unseen in society, all that you exemplify, we will all miss you, and I will specially miss you in some of the joint endeavors that we undertook, I always believe that a true leader is one who does not need any badge of honor or a rank. You will continue to be a leader, maybe in a new avatar. And I look forward to seeing you leading the younger generation, exemplifying what you all have stood for all these years: outspokenness, humility, and thoughtfulness for those whom we do not see. I wish you many, many more productive years and a healthy and peaceful life ahead. Adieu.
Hello, Justice Deepak Gupta ji. Amidst the confusion created by the pandemic, the date of superannuation has also arrived for you. Though in the normal circumstances we would assemble to bid you farewell, unfortunately we are not in a position to do so. Hence, I take this opportunity to address you through this medium and wish you well for the future. I am sure the post-retirement life would be enjoyed by you, and may the Almighty bless you with good health and all prosperity in future. Wishing you well once again. Thank you very much.
Brother Justice Gupta, passion for doing justice, patience in hearing the opposing views, and firmness in making decisions. I found these three elements to dominate your judicial thought process while sitting with you in the bench for a large part of my tenure so far in this court. It has been a wonderful experience. Wish you an active and fruitful life.
In our fairly long association, Justice Deepak Gupta has been a source of inspiration for hard work and institutional commitment. It was a pleasant coincidence that I went as Chief Justice to his parent High Court, which further cemented our personal relationship. I was very fortunate to have the blessings of Mataji at Shimla. Though Justice Deepak Gupta is demitting the office, but his legal acumen, hard work, and dedication will surely keep him busier than now. My best wishes and good luck to him.
Honorable Sri Justice Deepak Gupta, after rendering more than 40 years service to the judiciary, will be shortly demitting his office. After my elevation to the Supreme Court last year, I had an opportunity to share the bench with my Lord Justice Gupta on a couple of occasions. I found him to be a very good senior, guiding me in my initial days. I found him to be a great human being as well as a good friend. I am sure that the rich experience that he has gained, even after retirement, would be useful to you for rendering fruitful services to the nation and the society at large. I wish him all the best, a very good health and happiness to him and his family.
Honorable the Chief Justice and my esteemed colleagues, if I have to describe Justice Deepak Gupta in one sentence, it would be a wise man, a noble soul, and a fine judge. My first interaction with him and Mrs. Poonam Gupta was a chance meeting in 2016 when we were on our way to Gangtok, Sikkim. Since then, I have known that Justice Deepak Gupta and I share something in common, which is we both have a special place for Himachal in our hearts. I have had the privilege of sharing the bench with Justice Deepak Gupta on multiple occasions. Besides acumen and legal wisdom, he is sensitive and compassionate. But what I would cherish and always remember are the post-hearing deliberations, oral and by way of written notes. He was frank, open, forthright, but never shy to appreciate, a rare quality. His humility, straightforwardness, warmth and pleasant nature have touched and impressed everyone. I, like others, would miss him in the court and on the lunch table. 7th May is his birthday. I wish him a very happy birthday, good health and happiness always.
Good morning, Dr. Gupta. It would have been better if we had given you a send-off, joining together to all of us. But because of this unprecedented COVID-19, such a innovative method has been adopted in giving you a send-off. Please accept. You have completed 42 years of your journey in this legal fraternity and imparting justice. With such a flying colors, you are now at the meeting office. My good wishes to you. Brother, I can tell you one thing. I'm not losing one of my brother with the meeting office, but losing brotherhood. I've learned a lot from you, and only under your guidance, I have served the sake of people also. My good wishes to you once again. Please take care of your health. And wherever you stay, be positive and impart justice in any manner which is possible. And if I can be of any help to you, please give me a call. I'll always be there to provide my assistance to the extent possible. Thank you once again, Brother Gupta. Take care of yourself and health and the family. Thank you very much.
Good luck. Wish you all the best in post-retirement life. Sir, we'll miss you from chair number one of our Kamal launch. But you will always be in our heart. Take care. Good luck to you and your family.
This last 1.5 year, after the assumption of my office, what I could notice is Brother Justice Gupta is a soft-spoken and friendly judge. I had a very good time with him in the tea launch, as both of us were early birds along with few other judges. I did not have any opportunity to sit with him in the bench, but what I could find from his reported judgments, that he is very firm in his views. On the eve of his demitting office, I wish him all the best and pray Almighty for a happy, healthy and prosperous life for Brother Justice Gupta and all his family members. Thank you.
I've been meeting Brother Gupta for a long time, but I came to know him reasonably well when I was appointed to this court in November 2018. God has been extremely kind to give us both a common serving time at this prestigious court. I find Deepak to be warm and always ready to extend helping hand. My regret is that we are unable to give him a farewell on his supervision, befitting his temperament of being caring and hospitable. I will wait for good times to come and wish him a happy second inning of life. I will miss having someone to talk to in Punjabi with and sharing so much in common than just our surname. Wish you and Poonanti a happy and active retired life. This is just the ending of a new beginning.
Judgments of Brother Deepak Gupta reveal the qualities of brevity, lucidity of thought and expression, besides scholarship. More importantly, he stood by his oath in that the sturdy independence expected of a judge animated not only his judicial work, but also informed the lectures which he delivered. He had an abiding interest in the law relating to environment, human rights, jurisprudence, besides juvenile justice concerns. Justice Gupta is an amiable person. My brothers, sisters and I will surely miss him. Brother Gupta retires, as he must, but with honor. My wife and I wish Brother Gupta and his family the very best in a new, but hopefully more peaceful and certainly more lucrative phase of his life.
Dear Deepak Bhai, with your retirement, the institution is going to lose a fine judge who had an excellent judicial temperament, prompt in writing his judgments, and very independent and fair-minded. We are going to miss having coffee with you every morning, but you will have enough time to travel to the destinations which you have put on hold till now. Wishing you a very happy and healthy life with Poonam in your retirement. Lots of love. Bye, Indu.
Dear all, one can say that Justice Gupta and I are akin batchmates, since we were elevated to this court on the same date. Indeed, it was a privilege to have had him as a fellow traveller whilst navigating challenges that a new appointee faces. Justice Gupta is dear to all he works with, be it members of the bench or members of the bar. Personally, I am a huge admirer of his cool, calm and down-to-earth temperament. His demeanor and work ethic has indeed taken him a long way. I have often cited the example of how, through grit and determination, he ascended from practicing in the veils of Himachal to adjudicating at the apex court to motivate budding lawyers. While handling all the matters and tasks deftly, he has rendered very many significant decisions. I hope that the nation will utilize his services in other capacities in the future. I am sure that he will continue to make his presence felt through such service. I wish Justice Gupta and his family all the very best in this new chapter of their lives. God bless them.
Dear Deepak, this is wishing you many happy returns of the day and a long and fulfilling life ahead. Shivani and I both wish you on this occasion. We all, both of us, joined together this court and had a great bond developed, and that reflected also in our respective wives getting together and our joining over the dinners and the lunch tables. We'll miss you in your presence in the court, though the interaction has now changed with the Almighty intervening in the manner it has. I'm sure you will enjoy the 10-year post-retirement without the court proceedings. And it is not really a time to say goodbye, but for a different chapter to begin. And we'll keep in touch. Wish you all the best. And for your world, only for the time being from the court.
Hi Deepak, I wish you had a longer tenure. You are very knowledgeable and you have a very good judicial temperament. All of us will miss you, my friend. Have a happy and healthy retired life.
Brother Deepak, we would have celebrated this day of your retirement in a big way if the lockdown would not have been there. Even though I am not physically with you at this moment, my all good wishes are with you, your dear wife and your dear daughter. Everyone who adorned the bench of this highest court of the country has a limited period of work. You in your period of in office has shown extraordinary merit of an able, firm and thoughtful judge. You by your numerous judgment have made substantial contribution to the law of this country. The law reports bear testimony of your industry, vision and humane treatment of matters which came to you. I had opportunity to share the bench with you only for a week, during which period your conduct and performance made me your admirer and well-wisher. I wish you good health, happiness and more achievements in time to come.
Deepak, you represent an amalgam of the qualities which are required of a robust judge. Openness of mind, which is the quintessence of judging. Independence and integrity, without which judging can be in vain. Compassion, which is the hallmark of a sensitive human being. Command over first principles, which is sometimes a rarity in our times. Your abiding love for nature has translated into environmental jurisprudence, into the numerous judgments and orders that you have delivered. Your judgments above all, Deepak, reflect a firmness of resolve. Your contribution as a member of the Juvenile Justice Committee shows how sensitive a human being as an individual you are. Speaking for myself, I'll miss the morning coffee in the lounge with you every day. Cups of filter coffee interspersed with our humor and with our anecdotes, our stories about travel, about nature, and significantly, our search for liberal constitutional values. I hope that in the years of retirement ahead, you and Poonam will find time to spend time in your beautiful orchard and cottage.
Justice Deepak Gupta has been on this court for the short period of 3 years. In this short period, he has shown himself to be an independent and excellent judge. His judgments, particularly in the field of environment law, have helped this country enormously. I wish him well and hope that he can continue the good work done here.
I had the privilege of sitting with Brother Justice Gupta. I found him to be a very amiable person, well-read, upright, and is dependable in all respects. He is now retiring. He is in very good health and has energy to work. A lot is expected from him. I wish him all the best for his future and thank him for giving me very good company. I will miss him definitely.
Brother Deepak Gupta and Bhaviji. Brother, you have the unique distinction of being the first judge of the Supreme Court of India to receive a virtual farewell. Virtual because of the medium of communication. Our feelings for you are very real. Brother, we wish you fare thee well at the end of a long and illustrious career of 16 years. You will always be remembered as the great gentleman you are. not any the less for your erudite judgments. You will always have a permanent place in our hearts. I, on behalf of our colleagues and on my own behalf, wish you and Bhaviji the very best of everything in the days to come. Health, wealth and prosperity. Best of luck. Thank you.